हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम अगेन फॉर द न्यू सेशन ऑफ मैथ्स चैप्टर 5 लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। यस्टरडे वी हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट एक्सरसाइज 5.2 क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 एंड 4। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 and 6। ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट द लेसन। ओके, एक्सरसाइज 5.2 क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। इन द गिवन फिगर द आर्म्स ऑफ टू एंगल्स आर पैरेलल इफ एंगल ए बी सी equal to 70 degree, then find angle DGC and angle DEF. Listen children, when I am explaining, please look at the diagram and understand where these angles are there and where the letters are there. Okay. First one, let us find out angle DGC, how many degree. Okay, let me explain for that. In the given figure, you have to look at the diagram and line AB. See properly, line AB parallel to line DE and the transversal line, which one it is? BZ. Okay children, line AB parallel to line DE and the transversal is a BZ. Okay, now let us find out the angle DGC. Where is the angle DGC? Okay, angle DGC. Have you seen? Now let us see, angle DGC equal to angle ABC. How many degree ABC given? 70 degree. And see that angle ABC, that is equal to angle DGC. What type of this angle? What is the relation of these two angles? You know children, one is inside angle and other one is the outside angle. And the angle ABC and angle DGC are corresponding angle. If they are corresponding angle, what will happen? Their measures are also same. As it is, as the angle ABC equal to 70 degree, so angle DGC also 70 degree, because these two angles are corresponding angle. Okay children? Okay, so one angle we already got, angle DGC equal to 70 degree, because angle ABC and angle DGC are what type of angle? Corresponding angle. Their measures are also same. Okay, now let us find out angle DEF. In the given figure, again you see that line BC, carefully see that line BC parallel to the down line EF and transversal is DE. Here two other lines are there, line BZ parallel to line EF and the transversal DE, cut both the lines. Okay. Now let us see how to find out the angle DEF. And here when I am saying, all of you see that angles properly, angle GEF. Angle GEF equal to angle DGC. Okay children, see that properly. Angle DGC equal to angle GEF. What is that? What is the relation of these two angles? They are corresponding angle. So listen, the previous question number 1, the measure angle DGC equal to how many degree we got? 70 degree. Okay. So angle DGC we are already having 70 degree. So the angle DGC is equal to angle which one? GEF. Okay. These two angles are corresponding angle. So the corresponding angle measures are also same. So as the angle DGC is equal to 70 degree, of course the angle GEF, that also 70 degree, because these two angles are corresponding angle. Okay, now which angle we have to find out? DEF. So DEF is same as GEF. Listen properly, look at the diagram. D is at the top, DEF, that angle, that is equal to GEF. Both angles are same only. So the measure of the both angles are also same. That means angle DEF equal to 70, because angle GEF is already we got a 70. Okay, children, DEF equal to angle GEF. So the measure of angle DEF, that is equal to 70. I hope you are understood when I am explaining. All of you see the diagram properly. Once again, angle ABC equal to angle, which one? DGC. Because these two angles are corresponding angle. If the angle ABC is 70 degree, angle DGC also 70 degree because of corresponding angles. Okay, second one, angle GEF, that is equal to angle DGC 70 degree. Angle DGC we are already having 70 degree, so that is equal to angle GEF because these two angles are also corresponding angle, so their measures are also same. Okay, so next step, it is like that, angle DEF equal to angle GEF, both are same angle only. Okay, one is only the line letter is at the top written, but angle same only, angle DEF and angle GEF, both angles are same, so the measures also we got the same only. Okay, this way we have to find out the answer of question number 5. Children, now question number 6. 4 diagrams are given. Let us do one by one. In the given figures below, decide whether L is parallel to M. So, two lines are there. We have to find out two lines are parallel or not, and measures are also given according to that. Let us find out these two lines are parallel or not. And all of you look at the diagram. And line L and line M are cut by the transversal N. See all of you diagram. Here two lines are there. Line L and line M and transversal N cutting line L and line M. And two angles measures are also given there. 126 degree and 44 degree. These are the interior angles. The interior angles both are given there, 126 and 44. If you are adding both the angles, we are getting 170 degree, children. But this 170 degree is not equal to 180 degree. Okay, so we have already learned previously interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. That means the interior angles on the same side of the transversal, it should be 180 degree. It will be 180 degree. But here, if you are adding two angles, interior angles on the same side of the transversal, 126 and 44. If you are adding these two, we are not getting 180. We are getting only 170. As 170 is not equal to 180, and we can say that interior angles on the same side of the transversal are not a supplementary angle. So line L is not parallel to line M. Suppose if you are getting the interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, both the measures are 180 getting, we can say that this L and M are parallel. If 180 is not getting, the given two lines are not a parallel. Listen, children, that is the main thing. Interior angles on the same side of the transversal should be 180. Then only these two lines are parallel, we can say. Otherwise, if you are not getting 180, the given two lines are not a parallel. So, in the question number 1, we can say that line L is not parallel to line M because the interior angles on the same side of the transversal are not a supplementary, not getting 180 degree. Okay. Question number 2, whenever I am explaining, just have a look on the diagram, then only you will understand properly. Here, line L and line M are cut by the transversal N. The same only. Two lines are there. Line L and line M and one transversal, that is a line L. Okay. In the figure, angle A is equal to 75. Angle A equal to 75 because vertically opposite angle. Listen children, one angle is 75 and one angle is only A given. Listen, why I written A there? That is easy for find out the answer. Angle A equal to 75 degree. That means these two angle A and 75 degree angle are vertically opposite angle. Okay, that means 75 plus 75 we are getting how much? 150 degree. Listen, and here also 150 degree is not equal to 180 degree. Understand? So angle A plus 75 degree. Have you seen that? Angle A and 75 degree, we can say that interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Here also they are not supplementary. We are not getting 180. Okay, 75 plus 75, we are getting only 150. So line L is not parallel to line M, as it is as because of that the interior angles on the same side of the transversal are not supplementary, and these measures are not getting 180. Okay, I told you the previous one, if the interior angles on the same side of the transversal, it should be 180 degree. Otherwise, the given two lines are not parallel. Okay, this way we have to find out the answer of question number 2. Nothing is there. Very simple. Interior angle, one angle 75 given, and just opposite, vertically opposite angle I written there A. So vertically, as the vertically opposite angles are equal, 75 equal to A, and that A and another 75, they are interior angles on the same side of the transversal. If A is 75 and already one angle given 75, 75 and 75, if we are adding, we are getting only 150. That is not equal to 180. So of course the line L not parallel to line M. Okay children, now let us find out answer of question number 3. Here all of you look at the diagram. Line L and line M are cut by the transversal line N. Okay, in this figure, have you seen properly? I have written A in place of one angle, that A plus 123 degree angle, both are adding, we will get 180 degree because they are linear pair of angle. So both the angle together 180 degree, one angle is given, so we can find out the measure of angle A. So angle A is equal to 180 degree minus the given angle 123, will get 57 degree. So children, we already got angle A 57 degree. So angle A equal to angle B. See all of you, B also I written there. Angle A equal to angle B because what type of the angle? These two angles are corresponding angle. One is inside angle and one is outside angle. So angle A equal to angle B. So they are 57 degree because of corresponding angle. Hence we can say that here line L is parallel to line M. Okay children, see that the corresponding angles are also same getting, and 123 plus angle A, if you are that is equal to 180. So angle A is equal to 180 minus 123, we will get 57. So angle A is 57, angle B also 57. Here corresponding angles are also same, so we can say that the given two lines, that means line L is parallel to line M. Okay. The last question, number 4. See properly the diagram. Line L and line M are cut by the transversal N. In the figure, look properly. Angle A and angle 98 degree. These two are linear pair of angles. So, angle A plus 98 degree, that is equal to 180 degree because of linear pair of angle. So let us find out measure of angle A. Angle A is equal to 180 degree minus 98 degree. What you will get? 82 degree. children. Angle A we are getting now 82 degree. And see that angle A and angle C are what type of angle? They are corresponding angle. According to the law, the corresponding angles should be same measures. But see here, angle A we got 82 degree, but angle C it is written 72 degree. So here these two corresponding angles are not equal. So because of this reason, we can say that line L is not parallel to line M. Understood, children? First of all, angle A plus 98 degree equal to 180, because they are linear pair of angles. By using that rule, we have to find out measure angle A. 180 minus 98, we will get 82 degree. So angle A we got 82. And see the diagram, angle A and angle C, they are corresponding angles. I told you corresponding angles measures should be equal. But here angle C written 72, angle A got 82. They are not equal. Because of that reason, corresponding angles are not equal. So the given two lines, line L is not parallel to line M. Okay, children. So today we are going to wind up the session now. We have completed the lesson number 5 also. We have completed all the exercises. And you have to watch all the videos and copy down all the answers from exercise 5.1 and 5.2 in your maths notebook and learn. And no other notes are given from this maths lesson. You have to watch the video and write the answer. Okay. And we'll come with another video with another lesson. Till then, take care. Keep learning. Thank you.